I have fork in hand and I'm ready to chow down here at Kim's Cakes. But first, I want to meet the owner here in Rossford, Kim Thompson. Thanks for having us out today. I love this place. There's such good vibes in here. Tell me about why you started Kim Cakes and why you picked this location.
Oh, wow.
I threw a lot at you right there. First of all, hello.
Hello, Tim. Thank you for coming out.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
So I just started baking when I was a lot younger and decided to have a bake sale one day where I did slices. Mm-hmm. And from there, it kind of evolved because people felt like they didn't have to buy a whole cake, you know. So, and from that, it just kind of got noised abroad. In the back of my mind was always a dream to have my own establishment. 30 years later, I'm riding down Dixie Highway and this place chose me.
I love it. It drew you in.
Yes, it did.
Yeah, it was a target drawing the arrow, not the arrow heading to the target,
exactly.
More or less.
Sometimes I have to just sit back after everything settles. I have to just sit back and take it all in,
yeah.
Because it's just so, it's overwhelming, but in a good way.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very exciting. It's just every day it's a new adventure for me. I'm meeting new people. People come in and it's like they've been knowing me for years and really just met me. You know, like we hit it off.
Absolutely.
Right away.
You know, food is the best way, I think, to get to know someone.
Exactly.
Whether it's dinner or, in your case, desserts, sweets, which we're going to get into this beautiful tray here in a little bit. But baking, why was this something that you started at such a young age? Was it something that was passed down from your family?
Well, my dad had a sweet tooth, mm-hmm. And he could see that I enjoyed being in the kitchen. And so he asked me to make him some cookies. I made him some cookies, he enjoyed them, and from there, I just realized, hey, I can do this, and I enjoyed it. And I really enjoyed him enjoying it.
Mm-hmm.
So that kind of pushed me even more.
Isn't that what it's almost like that, I would say, probably for a comedian. They hear the laughs, and
right.
It's the people enjoying it. So it's the same way for a baker as yourself. You see people enjoying your food, and it makes you really love
right.
That passion even more. Slices of cake, that's how you started off. A specific cake?
I specialize in old-fashioned cakes.
Okay. Now, what is that, an old-fashioned cake? It's not like an old-fashioned drink in a cake.
No.
Right? Okay.
An old-fashioned cake would be considered a yellow cake with chocolate frosting, a German chocolate cake.
Personally, the first one you said, yellow with the chocolate frosting.
That's your favorite?
Yeah,
okay.
Absolutely. You have some in back. We're doing strawberry today, right?
Well, in the back, we're doing what I call vanilla and berries.
Okay.
Cute little story about that one. Last year for my birthday, I was going out with the girls for dinner, and I wanted to have a treat for them because that's typically what I do. So my friend asked me what I was bringing. I said, oh, just something I threw together. And it was just a vanilla cake with some strawberries and my signature buttercream. And they were head over heels for it. They was like, you need to call this thrown together. And I'm like, no. And so once I got in here, I said, I can't call it thrown together. I don't know if the people will receive. So I said, vanilla and berries. This is a Southern favorite, and it is called Seven Flavor Pound Cake.
I'm moving that around so we can see the frosting on the side. Seven Flavor.
I'm not going to tell you what those seven flavors are.
You're
want you to taste that.
You're a secretive person.
Yes,
right?
I am.
Because when we were talking on the phone, you said, I don't want to show my ingredients.
Yeah, I'd have to murder you.
Well, at least let me eat this first before you do that.
So you might taste a few. You can, if you get it, you can tell me.
Oh yeah, I'm picking some out in here. There's definitely a vanilla flavor to it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's an easy one, Tim.
Is there a coconut in there?
Yes, it is.
Okay. That's all I'm picking up, lighter
that's
flavors.
It.
I'm not getting a fruit.
You don't pick the peach brandy, huh?
Okay, peach I can see now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, absolutely.
Peach
but
brandy.
I think in my mind I was thinking more for like a harsher fruit.
Okay.
But you wouldn't want that in there. This
no.
is very light,
no,
easygoing. Would you throw some fruit on top to spice it up?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
A lot of people like fruit with their pound cake.
Mm-hmm.
I would put maybe some form of a berry because you don't want it too sweet.
Yeah.
You know, obviously because the pound cake is kind of sweet. So.
Absolutely.
I would do a raspberry, strawberry, or blueberry.
That would all work. And speaking of berries, you have this delicious when I was in here the other day, sugar-free cheesecake. Yeah. That you throw, we throw strawberries on top of that?
Yes.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
That was so good. I got to see you make the crust and go through that process, but when I got home, I had it and I was out the rest of the day because it was filling. But that was fantastic too.
The guilty, it's a pleasure that you can have without the guilt.
Yeah. I love that. That's a good way to use that. Okay, so what else do we have here? Red velvet. Good red velvet cake.
Espresso. Mm-hmm. Lemon and champagne.
Champagne. So we're here in January. I feel like we're still like on a New Year's kick, so I'm gonna go with the more celebratory. I like it. That's really, really good. It's light.
Champagne.
Mm-hmm. You can taste the champagne in there. Where do you get your inspiration for your flavors? Is it all up here, or do you get it from other people too?
Good question. Mm-hmm. So I'll start with espresso, because that is my first signature cake. I used to go to Starbucks every morning and get the caramel cappuccino latte. And so in doing that, the flavors would just kind of come, you know, I was thinking about what could I do to make this chocolate cake out of sight. And once I finally did that from having that latte every morning, there birthed that espresso cake.
World famous? Is that true?
Yeah.
Really?
We're working on world famous.
Okay, you're working on it.
World famous is my prophecy to myself. Something I'm shooting for. If you look at my map over there, I have conquered quite a few states.
You have, yes.
Brought to you locally by Dale Riggs Funeral Home. Funerals as unique as your life.